Good afternoon and thank you for joining us. My name is Lemo Mohammed.
And I'm Abby Govea. Today we have a local showcase planned that will excite and captivate you. From art hubs in the heart of Toronto to student work made right here at the Story Arts Centre. This is your one-stop shop for everything passionate within our city.
I'll also take you on a tour through the beautiful sights of the city's Hyde Park to the sounds and delights of Toronto's Music Park.
And we'll have special musical guest Matthew Alexander live in the studio. This is our annual showcase of the immersive work from Centennial College's broadcasting program.
With love from the Story Arts Centre, welcome to the gallery!
Today's gallery is all about the past and the present passion of here in Toronto. There's no better way to show you this than examining it through one of the hubs that fosters it every day.
The Riverdale Hub is a nonprofit that provides resources to the disadvantaged in Toronto. It is a beacon of passion and hope in our city.
Let's explore the artisan market. Artisanally Yours shares the story of Katrina Chan, who will guide us through a seasonal treat that empowers women to create.
My name is Katrina Chan. I am the Director of Operations of the Riverdale Hub. I started in 2020, and I've been here for 4 years. I handle the operations of both sides of the Riverdale Hub, a social purpose organization or social purpose enterprise. We've got the agency side, the Riverdale Immigrant Women's Center. We also have the Riverdale Immigrant Women Enterprises, which is the visible parts that you're seeing here, and that is the revenue generating piece. We began hosting these artisan markets in April 2022 with 15 vendors, so we've come a long way. For 22-23, we held six themed artisan markets that were pegged to some sort of celebration or city event. In this case, it was tied to Valentine's Day, but we tried to minimize that commercial aspect by calling it love and friendship, making it inclusive. And of course, we need love and friendship more than ever. So the themes are carefully thought out. We got a huge response, which we weren't expecting. It's starting to get to the point where we have to expand it. Whether or not we encourage more food vendors and drink vendors and maybe open up the bar for them. We had a record 21 vendors and over 200 visitors. Which we were really pleased with. Because we're small and mighty, I mean, we have a small staff. It's a nonprofit organization, obviously. And so a lot of us are stretched. And so we all contribute to all the programs. We promote via social media, our website, events calendar, blog TO, To Do Toronto, a lot of these events calendars hosted by other people. Most of our vendors are women exploring their artistic side, you know, through entrepreneurship. We had an exciting dynamic duo with a woman and her mother. They were a woman-owned, black-owned venture. The daughter, I believe, did the knitting and crocheting, and the mother did the beadwork. We've got vendors that keep coming back, but what I love about it is it's the handmade piece, right? And they usually use upcycled materials and they get really creative because there is that environmental, you know, aspect as well. So, and it ties to our mission, you know, of supporting marginalized populations as well.
An artisan market, isn't that a wonderful way to help create community in Toronto?
Oh, for sure. You can follow at the Riverdale Hub on Instagram if you want to hear about Katrina's next artisan market.
You know, Abby, that's what makes this city so great.
Wait, what do you mean?
It's the people. We are a city built on passionate people. Everyone has their own path, their story. Let's dig deeper into the life of those in Toronto. In these next two documentaries, we explore the hobbies of two students in broadcasting.
In Building Monsters, Arpad showcases his Gundam hobby, using concentration and skill to create unique and intricate monsters.
And then we'll look at my passion for music and art in my documentary called My Guitar.
So, I think out of the three I brought over here, I have like way more at home, but the ones I brought with me are the XS, Tri-Burning, and Aerial Rebuild is a really, really good one because you don't have to do eye stickers for that one.
There's a point early on when you're building and you're just trying to find everything. And so you gotta kind of like center yourself. By the way, for anybody who wants to speed up their builds, get a glass file. It's probably one of the best purchases I've ever made. It's a very smooth finish without having to go through like sandpaper and like polishing cloths. X-Acto knife is a viable option too, but that's mainly when you're dealing with white pieces because they won't get stress marks on them. This is very much putting me at risk of, like, a cut. Wow, look at that. That looks great. Fun fact, actually, my Turn A model, I keep coming back to it. That one has bits of my own dried blood in it.
Wow, that's some emotion there, buddy.
I am a little prone to the occasional cut. Oops, something's backwards. I don't know what's going on. Wish I had tweezers. Okay. We got him. I'm tired. It's been many hours, but we're in the final stretch, so let's do this.
Something I get asked a lot is, well, why not just buy an anime figure? Why go through all of this labor? Well, I can't get, you know, emotionally and physically invested in an anime figure in the same way I can in something like this. I mean, you know, some people do, but they're weirdos. But you buy a $70 figure, it'll have the articulation and the detail of a $30 model kit. You buy a $70 model kit, you'll have the articulation and detail of maybe $150 to $200 figure. So in that sense, it's such a better deal. And on top of that, you get this whole like experience out of it where the model effectively becomes like a reflection of you and how you were feeling at the time. And that gets translated through every little like stress mark and scratch and little deformation in the plastic. And I think that's irreplaceable. There's something special about that.
And there he is.
Now, I've had this guitar in my family for so many years. My family weren't musicians or anything, but it was just one of these things that we for so many years. When I was a kid, I've always wanted to learn how to play the guitar, and I would literally beg my mom to take me to guitar lessons. Unfortunately, due to our financial situation, she couldn't afford me to do so. But luckily, she found a place where we would go and learn.
Here we go.
So Beef 2, can you explain a little bit about the guitar?
The guitar has been in our family for many years. It is a very cherished family heirloom. And seeing you pick up the guitar from a young age and seeing how you've been playing it and practicing it throughout your life as you've become older is honestly something that's been very inspiring. And I think that everyone in the family really holds the guitar near and dear to our heart because, you know, as our lives change and as we grow up, a lot of different things happen. But that family heirloom still stays the same. And honestly, I feel like it really resonates with me because it symbolizes family, symbolizes unity, symbolizes the uniqueness of our family. And how we incorporate different musics and cultures in our family.
Now, I'm not going to say I'm the greatest guitar player around and all, but I don't know, I guess I'm not terrible, but I'm also not decent. I think what the motto should be is that, you know, you just gotta practice, and makes perfect. Despite me and my family not coming from a musical background, you know, this has been in our family for so many years, and I don't know, it's just too precious to throw away. Now, I don't expect to be a master overnight. You know, I'm gonna keep trying until I get it right. So, you know, that's just my family heirloom. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you then. I still need some work. What do you guys think?
You know what, Lemo? I think you gotta show us some of your skills.
Chill, fam. Well, Abby, I've got a surprise for you.
What is it?
We have a special guest here today.
Wait, what? Wait, I think I already knew that. I've been waiting forever to hear him live. Straight from the hustle and bustle, the heat of the art scene in Toronto. You know, there's so much musical talent on stage right now. Folks at home, get out of your seat. We've got Matthew Alexander here today. Hello, Matthew.
Hi, Matthew.
Hi.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, thank you so much for joining us. So, Matthew, I've heard today you'll be performing your song, Walking Through My Dreams Tonight. How did you originally get into music?
Well, all through my childhood, I had a history of doing choir and theater. And then these past couple years, I've been working on this track with my stepfather in our little home studio. So,
very cool. Yeah.
Matthew, what's your favorite thing about the Toronto music scene?
I'd have to say that just everyone I've met so far has been very friendly and collaborative and so talented, and I'm really excited to see what projects come out of the scene in the next couple of years.
Very cool. So what would you say are some of your inspirations?
I would probably say inspirations would be like Pharrell, Justin Timberlake, maybe The Weeknd, Childish Gambino, that kind of thing. Yeah.
Well, let's quit yapping. Live on the gallery, here's Matthew Alexander with
Walking Through My Dreams.
You're gonna kill this.
Do your feet get weak and tired? Walking through my dreams when I sleep at night. Can't stop, promise you I try, but you come back to me. I don't wanna be that guy. Ask if your friends and I tell a lie. Come on, baby, give me one more try now. One more chance to see. Do your feet get weak and tired? Walking through my dreams when I sleep at night. Can't stop, promise you I try, but you come back to me. I don't wanna be that guy. Ask your friends and I tell a lie. Come on, baby, give me one more try now. One more chance to see. If I'm honest, baby, if I tell the truth, I want nothing, baby, all I need is you. If I'm honest, baby, if I tell the truth, I want nothing, baby, all I need is you. Tell me you want me and tell me you need me to stay right by your side. But now things are different, see feelings and you run and hide. I hold and protect you only if you want to. It's hurting me deep inside. You tell me you love me, but you don't really need me. Do your feet get weak and tired? Walking through my dreams when I sleep at night. Can't stop, promise you I try, but you come back to me. I don't wanna be that guy. Ask you for friends and I tell a lie. Come on, baby, give me one more try now. One more chance to see. If I'm honest, baby, if I tell the truth, I want nothing, baby. All I need is you. If I'm honest, baby, if I tell the truth, I want nothing, baby. All I need is you.
Song here at the gallery.
What a vibe! It makes me want to get out and soak up the city.
How about we hit up a park, guys?
How about High Park?
You know what? Let's go. But, Lamo, I'm already supposed to walk together. Matthew, let's go!
Hi, everyone. My name is Lamo Muhammad, and today we're going to go on a great adventure today in one of the best parks in Toronto, High Park. Now, the three locations we're going to visit are the zoo, the hillside gardens, and the Grenadier Cafe. It's gonna be a great adventure, so why don't we hop to it? I'm on my way to the park. Meanwhile, Kieran is exploring another Toronto park space over the waterfront.
I'm Kieran, and right now I'm at the edge of Lake Ontario in the Toronto Music Garden.
Completed on June 10th, 1999, the Toronto Music Park, as it is known today, is home of Toronto's music heritage.
The garden was constructed over a span of 2 years, beginning in 1997 and finally opening to the public in 1999.
With the help of Yo-Yo Ma, who was a world-famous cellist, and Julie Messervie, who was a famous designer, the duo then band together to create a safe space for Torontonians to experience dance and rhythm.
Now back to Lamo and High Park.
The first destination we're going to go to is the High Park Zoo, so let's go over there right now.
Oh, we're good.
Oh, there we go.
Sorry.
I'm sorry. I'm a little scared of dogs.
Oh, no.
There you go.
Yeah. Hey. Here we are at the High Park Zoo. I am so excited, and I'd love for you guys to come join me. There's going to be llamas, emus, bisons, buffalo. Why don't you all come with me, and let's go inside. Wow, look at the llamas. How many llamas can you see?
He's so cute.
Moo. Hello, Mr. Moomy Moo.
Hello, Mr. Moom.
Whoa, is that an emu? You know, emus are birds that originated from Australia. Now, the thing about emus, unlike other birds, emus can't fly, but they can sure as hell run as fast, and they make this noise. Whoop, 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 whoop. Let's continue on.
The garden was designed as a series of six connected points, each aligned to a movement from Bach's suite. In the late 1950s, disagreements began on which path this park should take. This is what led to a decade-long expansion of the transit system in Toronto. During the summer, this garden turns
into an engaging cultural adventure. If you're in the city during the summer, come down here for some music.
Oh, wow. Those are a lot of stairs. Ah, is that the hillside gardens I see? Here we are at the hillside gardens. Now, it is a very beautiful garden, and as you see over there, there's supposed to be a big Canada logo made out of flowers, but unfortunately, it's the winter, so that won't show till the spring. But what I can say is that the Hillside Gardens has been a popular attraction since the 1950s. It has got the attention of photographers and lots and lots of visitors. Now, on my right over there, there is the Rock Gardens. It's just a garden full of rocks, and not much to say about the garden because it's snowing. However, I am getting a little thirsty and a bit cold. I see a cafe over there. Why don't we go check that out? Come on.
The landscape of this historic landmark tells a story of music, but most importantly, that of John Sebastian Bach and his suite for unaccompanied cello. Jonathan Sebastian Bach was a German musician and composer. He was born in 1685 and died at the age of 65. Walk away. Today, the Toronto Museum Garden continues to attract tourists and locals alike, and it serves as a space for creatives and artists like us to thrive and express ourselves.
Here is a monument, and this monument was erected back in 1978 because it celebrates the 25th anniversary when the Portuguese came to Canada. Well, everyone, we're at our final destination, the Grenadier Cafe. It was a cafe that was ran by the Grenadier Group ever since the early 1980s. You can get a lot of great breakfast here, like pancakes, French toast, scrambled eggs, etc., and coffee. And speaking of a coffee, it is really cold and I am getting kind of thirsty, so I'm gonna go inside and grab a coffee. But I hope you enjoyed this walk together. I really appreciate it, and I will hopefully see you next time. So I am Leo Muhammad. I'm gonna go get a coffee. This was our walk together.
You and Kieran killed it. Was that an emu we just saw?
Yeah, and it went like this.
Okay, Lemo, that's perfect. We decided to take you out of the studio and come upstairs to show you some of the passionate students and their artwork. The clay sculptures, take a look. I don't think I could probably ever do this.
Wow, they look really nice. Hey, this thing comes to mind.
Kind of looks like Ezra.
Oh no, probably looks like his grandfather, Greenspoon to Greenspoon.
That reminds me, did you see Ezra found his birth parents?
No.
Yeah, let's take a look.
He just had dinner with my birth mother a few days ago. How did that go?
It was amazing.
Yeah. Okay, good.
We hadn't seen her in 21 years, which is the last time you saw her.
Right, that was a while ago.
A long time ago. And she was great.
And somehow I'm not surprised it's a steakhouse. I wonder where I got my love of steak.
One of the most amazing things, Ezra, in this meal was that she had mannerisms, facial expressions and mannerisms, which were exactly like you.
She was so forthcoming. Any questions that you had that we asked her, it was no problem.
I'm glad. Answer.
Why can't I read? Somebody explain that to me. Could it be nerves? A little bit nervous. Boy, am I nervous. I don't know why, but I am. I have questions and I would like answers. I'm gonna read the email in its entirety.
Hi, Ezra. This is Kim. I had the pleasure of having dinner with your parents two nights ago. This is now several nights ago. It's been some time. We had a great time talking about you and how you've grown up over the years. Even after this many years, when I see the smiles on their faces and the happiness they have in their hearts, I know I made the right decision to have them as your parents. Okay. Number one, and the most important, who is my birth father? Your birth father was a man in the military. When I found out I was pregnant with you, I told him. That was the last I saw of him. I tried to find him through the legal route when I chose to put you up for adoption. I had to put an announcement in the newspaper. I have his name on my paperwork, and we'll get that to you. It was not a very long relationship. Okay, I don't have the name, but she'll get it to me. Okay. Two, what is my cultural background? Now, this is the big one as well. I don't know what culture I have in my background, so let's find out. This is speaking as my birth mother. My grandfather was German. Other than that, I only know of being Caucasian and having German in our ancestry.
Okay, I wasn't expecting that. Interesting.
I have no information on the cultural background of your birth father, not surprising, other than that he was Caucasian. Is there anything medically I should be aware of? We have had a couple of cancers in my family, but they were from smoking. Oh. Oh. Interesting.
I sort of anticipated not being known about, but to be invited down to be introduced to something I wasn't expecting. He just said...
I'm glad Ezra was able to find his birth mother. What a touching story.
You know what? I agree. You really can't take your parents for granted. Hey, Lamo, what's this over here?
Oh, I figured we should quiz each other on Toronto know-how. Famous figures from Toronto will pop up, and we've got to guess who that is.
You know what? You're on. Let's do it. Okay, first one. Okay, do you know who this is?
Drake.
It's Drake. And Drake. You guys can play along. Okay, let's go next one. Do you know who this is?
A monkey
Darwin. His name's Darwin. IKEA Darwin. I love this guy.
Austin Powers.
Austin Powers. I do not know who this is, okay?
Mike Myers.
Oh, okay.
Howie Mandel.
That is Howie Mandel.
The host of my favorite game show, Deal or No Deal.
And America's Got Talent. Very good.
Shawn Mendes.
This is Shawn Mendes. I went to his concert.
There's nothing holding me back.
Exactly. That's After Hours we're singing. This is Turning Red.
Turning
I
Red.
I haven't seen it. I don't know her name.
Me.
May.
May.
Turning Red.
Me, May. Ryan Reynolds.
My mom, she's probably watching. She loves
Deadpool and Wolverine coming out in July.
Ryan Reynolds. Okay, continue. This is one of my teachers. This is Malcolm Byard. Nice.
Where's his goatee?
Continue. That is the end of
the
game.
That was fun.
I had a lot of fun.
So did I.
You know what, Lamo? It was great exploring passion and especially in Toronto with you today.
Thank you, Abby. You were a great co-host.
You know what, Lamo? So are you. Okay, guys, thank you all so much. This is the time that we have from today. From everyone here at the gallery, thank you so much for watching our season finale. We hope you have an amazing summer. And from everyone here at the Story Arts Center, take care.
Until next time, this was the gallery.
Bye, guys.
Bye.